Para poder. Happy Easter. The Lord is risen. Happy Easter. It feels like Easter because it is Easter. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. As we continue with our celebration of Easter, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan? And all his works, and all his empty show. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? Amen. May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace for eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Oh,
O God, who by the abundance of your grace give increase to the peoples who believe in you, look with favor on those you have chosen and clothe with blessed immortality, those reborn through the sacrament of baptism, so that they may all grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, and by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them. For those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles. And they were distributed to each according to the need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God. And everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome. For whoever is begotten by God conquers the world, and the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is a victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. From the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When Jesus had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I sent you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But Thomas said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to Jesus, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to Thomas, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. Students that still have your Red Mass ticket for today, please bring it over. If you still have your ticket, one number, 147 is the number today. Just bring it over and I'll take it from you. Thank you very much. Just this part, not that, just this part. Thank you. That's great. Thank you very much. I can't believe it. You were even before me. Now you're going to go to the left pocket. Left pocket. That's it. Happy Easter. The readings of today and the celebration of the divine mercy of Jesus reminds me when I was 17 and heard for the first time that voice of God calling me to do something meaningful with my life. And I remember hearing that voice, not here in my ears, but like deep in my heart, "You can do this, you can do this." I heard that voice for the first time when I was 17 and I was attending a Holy Week retreat with the Dominican Fathers over in Mexico. And this is the seminary where they call it novitiate. So they are forming men into being religious. And I just saw what was in front of my eyes, their love for the liturgy, their passion for preaching. And I said, "I want to do that." And I heard in my heart, "You can do this. You can do this." And so I entered the seminary about 2 years later before I had to get baptized, because remember, I was in a Catholic. And so I had to get baptized, got the sacraments of initiations, just like some of you last week. And so I went to the seminary for the first time. And then I remembered that one of the things that they emphasize is seeking mercy. And so every time when we have a ritual in the Dominican order, right? Every time we have a ritual, there is a new prior, there is a new, in the government, when novices receive the habit, when after novitiate, when they make vows, profession, or you call it vows nowadays, the thing that they seek is mercy. And the formula is very clear. The prior or whoever is standing in front of them ask, "What do you seek?" And they say, we are to respond, "God's mercy and yours," meaning the mercy of God and also the mercy of the community that is welcoming us. That's a part of the ritual and a part of their lives. That's what Dominicans do. Dominicans train their men and also the nuns and the sisters to be people of mercy. That's the training, basically. And so I entered the novitiate, and then they asked me, "What do you seek?" "God's mercy and yours." And then I make vows for the first time, and then I say, "What do you seek?" "God's mercy and yours." And then I was seeking mercy, but 3 years later, I was saying goodbye to the Order of the Dominicans because I wanted to have some pastoral experience. That's how I ended up in El Paso. You know that part of the story. And then I left the seminary only for 1 or 2 years, but those 1 or 2 years became a total of 7 years. And when I left, I was 24, but when I was 7 years later, of course, I was 31. And I was realizing that what God had called me to do by saying, you can do that, you can just do it. I was 31 and I wasn't even close to being a priest. And so I thought, maybe if I go, maybe if they take me, maybe I can become a priest. And I went and knocked at the doors again of the Dominicans because that's what I knew. And then they asked me, what do you seek? And I said, I just want to go in and, you know, get ready to be prepared to become a priest. They said, what do you seek? And I said, God's mercy and yours. I re-entered the order. I did the novitiate again. I made my vows again. And then at the end for final vows, they asked me, what do you seek? And by then I was well trained. I said, God's mercy and yours, right? And then I was ordained a deacon, and they asked me, what do you seek? And I said, it's very simple, God's mercy and yours. And then I was ordained to the priesthood, and I said, okay, now I am a priest, and I'm going to be ordained for the order of preachers, and I will remain here for the rest of my life. They asked me, what do you seek? And I said, God's mercy and yours. And 3.5 years later, I was saying goodbye to the order of preachers. And then I was coming into the diocese. And by then, because I had been well trained by the Dominicans, the bishop didn't ask me, what do you seek? He asked me, actually, what do you want here? Because you don't belong here. And I said, I just want to have the opportunity to work as a diocesan priest in your diocese. So he welcomed me. And from then on, the rest of my story, some of you know, because I've known you for almost 13 years. And what I seek in life is God's mercy and not the friars anymore, because I don't live as a Dominican friar anymore, but I live my life dependent on God's mercy and yours. Today, when we celebrate the mercy of God, we also remember that God never ceases to give his mercy. See, if you pay attention to the gospel of today, what happened is really the resemblances of mercy from the bottom up. Jesus came on a Sunday like last Sunday, right? The day of the resurrection, that's what the gospel says. On the day of the resurrection, later in the day, Jesus appeared to his disciples that were hiding because of fear of the Jews, because they thought they were going to get killed just like the master did. They didn't want to get killed, and no kidding, no cap. I didn't want to be killed either. You know, if I would be one of the disciples of Jesus in Jesus' time, I would have hid also. So Jesus comes and he says, you should have stayed with me on the cross. Is that what Jesus said? You chickens, you abandoned me. Is that what Jesus said? No. He says, peace be with you. As the Father sent me, so now I sent you. Go and forgive people's sins. And the next week, when Jesus comes back, the disciples are already doing that, right? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? No, they are not doing that. Jesus sent them off to forgive people's sins. He says, whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. Whose sins you retain, they are not forgiven. That's now your job. And he comes back later, a week later, on a day like today, just to check things up, right? But in fact, he finds them still in hiding. They didn't do what Jesus asked them to do. They stayed in the room in hiding. They didn't do what Jesus asked them. Oh, but then Thomas comes by, and Jesus is like, okay, Thomas, what were you saying about me? Where do you want to put your fingers? Excuse me. Where do you want to put your hand on? Because I'm here just for you. Just in case you had forgotten what you said, I heard you. And Thomas is like, my Lord and my God. To this day, we still say that prayer, right? My Lord and my God. And Jesus, again, he sends them. And the gospel doesn't tell us whether they did go or not. What do you think they did? The proof that they finally got it, that they finally received Jesus' mercy and were able to give it to others, is this. Not this building, but this, the church. I said it the other day in passing, if they would have not done what Jesus asked them to do, you and I would not be here. We would have never known about Jesus because they would have just kept in hiding. We know about Jesus because they finally decided to do what Jesus asked them to do. Right? So we owe to the disciples the fact that they just decided to just do at some point in their lives, stop from hiding, go out, and start proclaiming what Jesus had asked them to do, what Jesus had taught them. They did that, and down the line, down the centuries, that's how you and I are here. We are here worshiping Jesus, knowing about Jesus, and praising his name because they made the decision to go and do what Jesus had asked him to do. But in the first place, it's because he did not chastise them, he did not punish them, he did not put them in jail. He didn't replace them. I said the other day, if I would be Jesus and I go and tell you to do something and you don't do it, you get two more chances. And I mean it. You get two more chances, right? I'm going to tell you one more time to do it, and you better do it. By the third time, if you have not done it, I tell you a third time, three times. You don't do it, I'm out, I'm off. You know, don't bother me anymore. I don't care. You can start doing it again. I don't care. I don't give the time of the day. Why? Because I told you three times and you didn't do it. But thank God Jesus is not Jairo. Because he doesn't give up. He doesn't give up on people. And so what we celebrate today is that great mercy of God that he has always, always, always ready, no matter what. And I hope that you learn, even if you're not Dominicans, right? I hope that you learn more and more to depend on God's mercy and the people around you. You husbands and wives, you depend on the mercy of your spouses. You children, you depend on the mercy of your parents. And parents depend on the mercy of their children. You depend on my mercy, and I depend on your mercy. No mercy, no Jesus. Amen? No mercy, no Jesus. Amen? If we want to make Jesus present in the world, we start by making mercy present. And mercy is hard. Mercy is no game. Giving mercy to you, my friends, and, you know, close people, and those my 90%, it's good. Giving mercy to my 10% is hard. Giving mercy to those who say bad things about me, or who don't like what I do, or who do not even pray for me, giving mercy, and I know who they are. Not because I am Padre Pio, right? No, I just know who people are because I saw them when they come my way, right? Giving mercy to those is very hard, but I was well trained. You give mercy because you received it first. The more mercy you receive, the more mercy you and I are to give. And I have, for once, I'm just going to tell you this. For once, I'm telling you, I have received so much mercy, I can't stop but just giving it away. But you still get three times, okay? You can still, the cutoff is three times. I tell you three times, and I'm just going to wait for you to do it. If you don't do it, I'm going to give you a chance. I'm going to give you a chance, okay? Some of you who work very close with me, and you know what I'm saying is not an exaggeration. I really try my very best, even if my cutoff is three times, I try to overlook that and give you one more opportunity because I have received plenty. I give you mercy because I have received more mercy than you can imagine. I have received so much mercy that without it, I would not be standing here in front of you. That's how much mercy I've received. And I am here being who I am, not because of what I am or what, but because of who God is. And that's why I decided to, even though I'm not a Dominican anymore, I don't live with the friars anymore, it is my joy to receive and depend on God's mercy and yours That's the way to be. You give mercy, you receive mercy, give it away. Don't hold it on. Don't hold it with you. Give it away. That's what Jesus said. Whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. Whose sins you retain, they are retained. Give mercy, just like he did to the disciples. Even though he was misunderstood, people didn't do what he wanted them to do, what Jesus wanted them to do. It was just a mess. Jesus' life, when you look at it closely, Jesus' life, poor thing. I mean, he made water into wine. He opened the eyes of the blind. He gave Lazarus a new life. And people would not believe in him. But he did not give him three times. He didn't give him three times. His cutoff is forever. He doesn't have a cutoff. His cutoff is mercy. So let us depend on God's mercy and yours. No, God's mercy and yours. Now you say amen. The Lord is risen. Since we have already professed our faith, let us present our prayers and needs to the Lord.
Let us pray for the church, for ourselves, that we may bear of God's mercy to all who need it most, especially those who find themselves doubting God's presence in their lives or in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for an end to armed conflict and to gun violence, so that all God's children may enjoy the peace that Jesus offers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all those who struggle to believe in merciful God in the face of evil and in sin in the world, and that Jesus' promise of his redemptive presence in a broken world may strengthen their faith and give them hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our donors, ministries, families, children, the elderly, and the unemployed, that the Lord will see to their every need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the repose of the soul of Aurora Bravo, Phoenix Juan Galvan. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer. Let us also pray for our intentions and the intentions of about 90 families that pray with us this time, that God may, that we may give to others the mercy that he has given us. Let us pray to the Lord. And we pray for vocations. Jesus, our Savior, you circled heartfelt compassion when you looked upon the crowd and saw that they were like sheep without a shepherd. We know that the harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So we ask you, the master of the harvest, to send out more laborers. Open my heart and the hearts of my brothers and the sisters to your will. Raise up joyful young men and women who are open to grow in holiness and devotion and spend themselves for your people in the Diocese of Austin as nuns, sisters, monks, brothers, friars, permanent deacons, and priests. May no one in your flock, won at the price of your blood, be without a shepherd to guide them. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We now take a moment to prepare our offerings. Father, we thank you for making your mercy present in our lives through the person of Jesus, who never, ever, ever gives up on us. We ask that you please accept the offerings we bring to your altar today through him who rose from the dead and lives and reigns forever and ever. Father, we thank you for your mercy that is endless in our lives. We ask that you please accept these offerings from your church and give us more mercy that we may in turn give it to others, especially those who need it the most. Through Christ our Lord. Pray, friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those who have been brought to new birth by baptism, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism they may attain unending happiness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is really right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For Christ is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, he has restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, with Joe our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and the sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
If you cannot receive Holy Communion today, please say this prayer with me. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Once a month, we pick up a special collection that is destined to help with, that is destined to help us with the maintenance of our buildings and whatnot. So if you would like to contribute to this special collection, please, you don't need to wait for me until I finish. Just go ahead. You don't need to wait for me. So if you would like to contribute, that's fine. If not, that's still fine. Just so that you know, the new air conditioner unit that we have in the parish hall is because of these donations, right? The remodelings that are happening at the Holy Cross, at the Sacred Heart Center, they're also a part of this, goes to that as well. So we are putting your money to good use. So thank you for your help. Okay, we would like also to congratulate those of you who are celebrating your birthdays anytime in the month of April. Do we have any April birthdays today? Okay, we have a few. That's great. Fabulous. Congratulations, congratulations. Also, the evangelization communities are having brunch and lunch today. If you would like to partake of the delicious food they've prepared, they are outside. Where are you? ¿Dónde están? ¿Aquí? ¿En el salón o dónde están? So they are in the parish hall right now, and later on they will be by the playground. That's great. You have heard me saying this, but I'm going to say it one more time. If you are bilingual in Spanish, please get your ticket to attend the Women's Conference this coming April 20th. The date is approaching, and so get your ticket today at the parish office or online if you would like to. Also, the Spanish Eucharistic Congress is going to be next month, so there's going to be people, I think, outside for the both of them giving information and selling tickets if you would like to buy your ticket. And if you would like to have your candles and rosaries and other things blessed, please stand with your things in your hand, please. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Amen. Blessed be your name, O Lord. You are the fountain, source of every blessing, and you look with delight upon the devout practices of your children. Draw near, we pray, on these your servants, and as they use these symbols of their faith and devotion, grant that they may also strive to be transformed into the likeness of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Yes, you. Last year, one of our parishioners, whose name I will not say, but she's standing on my left, she came with the wonderful idea of celebrating divine mercy and promoting the divine mercy of Jesus. And I said, well, okay, go girl, go get it, you know, go ahead and do it. And, you know, people come up with a lot of good ideas, but when I say go ahead and do it, they don't make it. She is different. When she says she's going to do something, she will do it. So we have a group of people that have been praying the Divine Mercy during these days, the Divine Mercy Novena. And so today we are going to do the consecration of the families to the Divine Mercy of Jesus. Okay. If you, I'm going to say it in a minute. Okay. Very nice. So this is a group that has been promoted in the parish. Lupe has been heading this effort. And also, if you are enamored, if you have a special place in your heart for the Divine Mercy of Jesus, and you would like to consecrate your family to the Divine Mercy of Jesus, please stand and come forward, because we want to see where you are. No? No one? Okay. So Maria, thank you very much. Okay, please come forward. Please. Si quieren consagrar sus familias a la divina misericordia del Señor Jesús, pueden pasar en esos momentos, ¿sí? And you're welcome to kneel if you're still able to do so. If you're not, that's okay. That's okay. Oh Jesus, you showed us your infinite compassionate love by exhausting the very last drop of blood and water from your body. From this day forward, with full confidence, we entrust these families to your divine mercy. We abandon our past, our present, and our future. We place into your wounds all of our wounds, which are caused by lack of love, understanding, and trust. Jesus, expel Satan and all evil from our families. Free us from the consequence of sin and protect us from further harm. Heal our wounds. May our families learn to venerate your divine image, that they will never perish, but experience your loving mercy. Oh Jesús, nos mostraste tu infinito amor compasivo hasta agotar la última gota de sangre que había en tu cuerpo. De ahora en adelante, con confianza entera, confiamos nuestras familias a tu divina misericordia. Abandonamos nuestro pasado, nuestro presente y nuestro futuro, y lo ponemos en tus manos. Ponemos en las heridas tuyas todas nuestras heridas, las que resultan de la falta de amor, entendimiento y confianza. Jesús, expulsa a Satanás y todo mal de nuestras familias. Libéranos de la consecuencia del pecado y protégenos del daño que nosotros podríamos hacernos a nosotros mismos. Cura nuestras heridas. Que nuestras familias aprendan a venerar tu imagen de la divina misericordia para que nunca perezcamos, más bien al contrario, tengamos una experiencia de tu misericordia y de tu amor. Te consagramos a estas familias por Jesucristo nuestro Señor. Amén. Muchas gracias. Y muchas gracias, Lupe, por... Thank you very much for carrying this effort, okay? God bless you, my dear. God bless you, my dear. Okay? Thank you, Lupe. Thank you. Okay. So as we have been doing during this school year, every month we have a winner of the mass attendance. So everybody who attended mass last month, in the month of March, their names are here. I wish I could give you all a gift, but I can't, right? So, but we can give one person one gift. So would you like me to take the name from up above or under? To the right or to the left? Huh? In the middle? Okay, middle down, okay? Okay. Okay, this is the middle. And the winner is Adriana Mendez. She's with Grace Gomez. Is she here? No? She's one of your students, Grace. Oh, she went to restroom? I'm telling you, you have to just make a choice. You come to mass or you come to the restroom. You can't do both, right? You can't do both. So let's wait for her. Adriana Mendez, she's in Grace Gomez's class. Anyway, so that's it. The rest are a bunch of losers. That's all of you here, right? But keep coming. Maybe one day it'll be your time, right? Thank you very much. No, you're not losers. You're a bunch of winners. We don't like losers here. Now, okay, so we're going to... Oh, okay, I know who she is. Okay. Very nice. Very nice. We were just talking about you. Can you believe it? My goodness. My goodness. So you are the winner. You're the winner. This is your ticket, and this is, she's going to give you something else when your parents are here, okay? Okay, congratulations. God bless. God bless. Okay. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia. 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 That's great. You are welcome to join the choir. Over there on my far left, there is a bunch of rice bowl boxes that students in the religious education program They made them themselves, and so they are all ready for a contest. So this is what you're going to do. You're going to look at the one that you like best, and you're going to vote only one time. Parents, only one time. Students, only one time, okay? The one you like, you vote one time, and you deposit the vote in the plastic box that is there, okay? And you do that after the final song, of course, right? Happy Easter!
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Regina Celi, letare, alleluia. Qui aquae meruisti portare, alleluia. Resurrexit, sicut dixit, alleluia. Ora pro nobis Deum, alleluia. And may the souls of our faithfully departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment.
Please do not forget to vote right here on my left. On your right, there is where you can vote. You don't need to present your ID to vote this time. And then the tickets for the Women's Conference are up in the front and in the parish office as well. God bless.